All right, we have a full house, four players.
Full house? It sounds like a card thing.
Here. I don't think I've ever played this game with four people.
And 30 seconds, people.
I think I've always, only made it to two.
Okay.
Are you interested in divesting some instructional adenoids?
Doing instructions?
Do you guys need instructions on how to press these four buttons to answer questions?
To the joke.
Yeah. Microphones between me and the screen.
There's a timer tickling away, so the more expeditiously you buzz in, the more remuneration you'll receive.
These are how you answer questions.
Or forfeit. And Cookie, your MC,
ow.
Will be endowing you
just
with
did it again.
Use the screw if you see
just made my leg jump.
Ah, you're in a hurry. I see.
Wait,
begin the commencing.
I don't give a shit.
You can screw everyone. If you activate your screw.
Today's wrong answer of the game is brought to you by Bernie's Baby Browning Tanning Beds. Get your baby.
Bernie's Baby Browning
today.
Tanning Beds. So that's our clue. One of the questions is going to have a wrong answer that's related to that somehow. And that's going to be worth a bunch of points. But by the time it comes up, we're all going to forget about that anyway. So Baby Browning Tanning Beds.
Yes.
First, that is some handsome debt. Because it's closest to the card color associated with soccer penalties, which credit card might David Beckham give Victoria to pay for her many extravagant
what?
Celebrations? Visa
what?
Black, American Express Green, Discover Platinum, or Gold MasterCard?
Oh, God. Oh, God. Gold. Why did I say my answer out loud? God damn it.
Three. I'm sorry to inform you, but your answer has been denied.
I like it when you people are all wrong. Yes.
The gold MasterCard would be closest to a yellow card, a penalty card which FIFA
I'm a genius, and I don't know who Mineral is.
Extravagant celebrations,
who's Mineral?
Such as removing one's shirt after a goal.
Alright, so I'm player one.
Victoria's shopping sprees are all being caught on
so I'm player one, Andrew's player two, Joe's player three, Alyssa's player four.
Yeah.
We're gonna have a grand little adventure.
Is it too loud?
Probably.
Coming up next, baking a cake with his bare hands.
Yeah.
How cool is Bear Grylls, that dude from
what?
Man vs. Wild, surviving harsh elements with only a plastic
pop culture
cone.
Reference!
Awesome. Suppose Bear Grylls baked a layer cake to celebrate his return from the Amazon. If the four layers of the cake represented the four layers of the rainforest, which part would be the top layer?
Oh, God.
The fudgy forest floor layer, the fruity understory layer, the caramely emergent
well,
layer,
duh.
Or the chocolate... score.
Oh, it's emergent, isn't it?
I was gonna say somebody watched Tarzan.
There's only one other one it could be.
And the emergent layer. And the
I wanted someone to put forest floor.
I heard that Bear Grylls is actually a very good cook. You'd never know it from watching Man vs. Wild, but I guess he makes an amazing souffle made with banana.
You're gonna have to speak up, Joe. If you're gonna talk to the microphone.
You're racist.
It's time for emotions. Which letters from a Windows version name can also mean dead when used as an emoticon? N E M E S E or X P?
What? What?
Player one.
I don't.
Nay.
Don't make fun of me.
Three and
four. I don't know what I'm doing.
XP in emoticon language can mean dead. The X is for the X'd out eyes of the dead person,
oh.
And the P is the dead person's tongue sticking out.
I didn't understand the question.
Which makes sense. I mean, most dead people.
Yeah, that's how this is always gonna be. Am I winning still?
No.
I can't tell. Damn it.
Wow.
We're all negative, aren't we?
Say hello to USA, the network.
Oh shit,
Alyssa
is gonna win.
They named a country after it. USA Network slogan, characters welcome, really confuses me. Am I the character?
Because they have the most awful characters
network?
Ever.
In which case, thank what, you, USA. Or are there characters welcome? On their
USA.
Shows, and I'm not the character,
an
and
awful
does that
channel.
Mean I'm not welcome? I wonder if they could make it more confusing. Suppose the USA Network changed their slogan to characters based on other fictional characters welcome. Which of these shows would they air?
What?
Notice, House, Monk, or Psych?
Oh, fuck. What? I think they want to. I think they're asking you which show doesn't air on USA? No.
Players 2 and 4? That's right!
Yep.
Ah.
Oops, I didn't say psych. I guess that was kind of implied.
Oh, wow.
Honestly. Dr. Gregory House's character is based on Sherlock Holmes. You know, the detective.
Well, so is Psych.
Also, little known fact.
Psych is also based on
Sherlock Holmes. Okay. Those, they're all USA shows.
Yeah, but Bones wasn't on it.
Yeah. Oh, you just got burned. And now, so or infant.
I forgot the question already.
Courtesy of Bernie's Baby Browning Tanning Beds. Baby, say bye-bye to embarrassing diaper
Joe might win now.
Today. This wrong answer of the game got you $4,000. Nice job.
I have to get this right?
No, you got it already. There's a wrong answer of the day in every episode where one of the wrong answers is hinted at the beginning of the show. And if you get it later on, you get the points for it. But no one ever
remembers. I thought Bird Notice was based on fiction.
Don't say I never gave you anything.
I'm in last place.
And try to improve your
Fuck.
Score. I'm gonna read off seven names, and for each one, tell me if it's
I only got one answer right
so far.
A world
capital city, or
oh shit,
a fashion designer, where or where, if you will.
This ought to be good.
Geology capital, fashion.
Press your X.
If it's
so, I have to guess if it's a world capital or fashion designer, which between two buttons, and you guys have to try to beat me to the answer. You try to lock in your answer before I get it, because if I get it wrong. You get it right, you get points. I'm gonna skip to the tutorial. That's it. Just keep you guys just guess too as fast as possible.
Yeah.
What?
Burberry, Unzara, Montevideo, Dakar, Hermes, Damulamis.
What? Okay.
I got $3.
I'm amazing. I got
right now.
Positive one question. Okay. Still negative.
Woo! Vegetable? Who the fuck is named Vegetable?
That's that. Hey,
you
chose a vegetable.
Oh, I'm Animal. What the fuck?
I just kind of started alternating X and B. I kind of just started alternating X and B. I'm in third place still. Shit.
Don't forget, all the questions in round two are worth double. And let's see some screwing out there. You're being too nice.
Oh yeah.
Six is a robot.
Did we sink it?
Here's one for
no.
you.
Turn
oh, well.
Your
head
oh, yeah,
to
I
the
did.
Left and Kaufman.
What?
For accuracy's sake, how should I change the lyrics to REM's Man on the Moon?
Oh
if
god.
If you believe they put 5 men on the moon, if you believe they put 9 men on the moon,
oh,
if
god.
You believe they put 12 men on the moon, or if
oh,
you
god.
Believe they put 18 men on the moon.
Oh god.
Players 1, 2,
I don't
three.
Know.
Well, if you believe that, you are wrong. Player 4. 12
wow,
men have walked on
money.
The moon's surface, beginning with
did
Neil
you actually
Armstrong
know that,
and ending with Harrison
are you guessing?
Schmidt in 1972.
We all guess, I think.
Did you actually know that?
If you ask me,
it sounded about right. I
was
like,
so did 9.
Yeah.
No, 9 was cheese.
What? It's the moon. 9 sounds like a good amount of people sent to a fucking other planet.
No other
oh,
countries
other moon. Moon.
Moon. So.
I just stepped in something ugly.
Yeah, only the United States has made
it
to the moon.
A stylish pair of Ugg boots. If every time you take a step, the boots let out an Ugg sound, what would that be an example of? A malapropism, an oxymoron,
got it.
Assonance, or
I got the right answer first. Fuck all you guys. High
oh
score.
High score. High score.
Oh, wait. Damn it.
You were cheating. You
were
cheating.
Players 2 and 4. I think the
wow, you guys all got it wrong.
Here.
Player
1.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Onomatopoeia is a word that imitates the sound it represents, like Ugg.
Oh.
But if your Uggs really are making noise every time you step, you might want to double check and
yet?
Make sure you're not wearing actual lambs.
Oh, neat. I'm going to win.
Walking chicken is picking out a mate. Guess I'll marry hate.
Why were they
Here's
in prison?
What I like to call
why did that take place there?
Which of these famous brothers would effectively be able to rule a tetrarchic government?
What?
The Baldwin brothers, the Blues brothers, the Bacon brothers,
what?
Or the Jonas brothers?
Oh, okay. I think I figured it out. Oh, I think I just got it wrong.
Player 3?
I don't know.
No.
Tetrarchic means four, right?
I bet you're burning up for getting that answer wrong. And I apologize for referencing a song by the Jonas Brothers.
Did we get it?
No.
Oh.
It would be Baldwin Brothers.
Does Tetrarchic mean five?
Would be ruled by three? Four people, and there are four Baldwin brothers.
Yeah.
I thought there was four Jonas Brothers.
No, there's only three Jonas Brothers.
Oh, I'm not thinking of One Direction. I don't know what that is. You're making something up. I think I just assumed that old boy bands had four people.
And now, I base it on nothing. For someone who accepts who I am.
What?
Suppose on their first date, Olive Oil revealed to Popeye that she had an acidic level between 1% and 2%.
What?
Oh,
God.
Made her olive oily speaking. An extra extra virgin, an extra virgin, a virgin, or a hoe.
What? What? Are we talking about alcohol?
No, we're talking about olive oil.
I don't understand.
Olive oil! 1% or 2% olive oil.
In order to be classified as virgin olive oil, the acidic level must be more than 1% and less than 2%.
I guessed it on accident. Awesome.
Oh, really?
I don't know what these things mean.
I thought it was extra virgin.
Oh, I just called it a
I didn't understand this question. I just got it.
Excuse me.
You get a voice for calling her a hoe.
No.
Oh no.
Whatever, I have the. Wow, that one just went right through the zero. Oh shit!
The baby.
E-I-E-I-Ow. Which farm animal actually has the balls to rule the barnyard? A capon, a gelding, a ram, or a steer?
What? Oh. I get it. I think.
Yeah. Which one has the biggest testicles?
I just think it means which one has testicles, period.
Layers 3 and 4. Nope, a steer is a young ox or cattle who's,
a ram is male. A gelding was male, but not... It's got shit taken off.
The ram's the only farm animal here who's not castrated, so the ram's got it in the bag.
Those are all castration names? That's horrifying.
And if you think about it, rams do look kinda horny.
I'm gonna kill him. Here comes lightning round.
Brace yourself for. I'll just shut my mouth.
Does everyone know what to do? Here's someone just today.
CGI people, real voices.
You have to
these
hit. There's gonna be something related to the clue. It's like clue in the center, and then like random stuff to match them up by hitting A. What? Oh, come on. Joe got it. Oh, what? God damn it, why did I think it was Tim Allen?
I don't know.
Chef Woody from, Woody's from Toy Story. Yes! Jack Black. I have no fucking clue. What? Zach Braff has jobs? Who is giving him jobs?
Come on, guys.
I don't know who did. Marmaduke. I don't know.
Oh, shit.
I don't know. Was it Owen Wilson?
No.
I don't know. You're.
Stop it.
Don't listen. Don't be that person.
My bad. I thought it was.
You're just gonna break everything.
Yes.
I don't know who this person. I don't know who Marmaduke is.
Let's be boy.
That would be pretty funny. I don't know who does Marmaduke.
Oh, well,
I guess now
no
I do.
No one's read Marmaduke in my 20 years.
Negative 59,000.
Player one takes it.
How did I?
Wow. Wow, I thought I was losing the worst.
Oh, no, no. I went from being first place to just, nobody cares.
Oh, because you can't press an A.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Don't be that person, though. Because then you'll steal the right answer, too. And then no one gets to play at all.
Nice one, folks.
And that makes people sad. Then you're like my little brother who doesn't like playing games that he's losing.